the Malibu World Disco Dancing Championship of 1983.
Four days ago, young people from 32 nations converged in London to compete for the most coveted title in the world of modern dance. Since their arrival, their feet literally haven't touched the ground.
It's 9 o'clock now. We're on the air at 8 o'clock tonight, and it's a one-way trip. It's not as if we're recording the show, it's a live show, so at 8 o'clock we've absolutely got to go. As you can see, the set still isn't finished. Set's still being built. Bruno's going to do the choreography. You all got to listen very, very carefully to what Bruno tells you, because I'd like just to be able to rehearse each number once this morning, and then when we go for the dress run's got to be as near to the actual show as we can make it.
Yes, absolutely. The first thing, I'm sorry, but the first problem is that we have to change a step, yeah, because the stairs, where we didn't have at rehearsals, are too steep, so we can't do the turns on the stairs. So before we start, I have to change a few steps, yeah, so we can adapt the dance routine to this new setup.
Can we go with that routine now?
Yeah.
Normally we've got 16 competitors. This week we've got 32.
32
of you. So it's going to be very, very crowded. We've got to make the best of it. But the most important thing is that you enjoy the show. If you enjoy the show, the viewers, all those viewers coming home on a wet November evening to see you, will enjoy the show as well. So go for it. Good luck, and make it work.
Tonight, from the Empire Ballroom in London's Leicester Square, the Malibu World Disco Dancing Championship for 1983. Starring 32 of the world's best disco dancers, your hosts, Lee, John, and Yolanda, and special guests, Imagination, Mezzaforte, and Second Image. 32 dancers arrived in the British Isles and today descended on a tiny island precinct in the heart of London's West End, known as Leicester Square. Now, for one magical night, the Empire Ballroom becomes the island of their dreams.
Finding the just fantastic. We carry on a tradition here at tonight at Empire Ballroom as our search for the best disco dancer in the world comes to an end for 1983. In less than an hour, one of the 32 national champions with us will become the fifth holder of the international title. Transported with us to this tropical setting to choose a new world champion, our distinguished panel of judges, who are our non-voting chairman, managing director of Concord Management and Promotions, organizers of this championship, Louis Parker. Responsible for Danceworks, where rehearsals were held, Benny Gray. And a lady whose birthday it is today, the equally lovely and talented songstress, Hayward.
Happy birthday to you.
Representing our overall sponsor, Malibu, Peter Cox. Fashion coordinator of the TV Times magazine, Gillian Fitzmaurice. Woo! From County Sound Radio, Britain's top club disc jockey, Steve Walsh. Renowned international choreographer of films like Annie, as well as being Britain's number one exercise and dance teacher, Miss Arlene Phillips. The artistic director of Vidal Sassoon, worldwide official hairstylist for this year's championship, Christopher Brooker. And dubbed the United Kingdom's number one radio disc jockey, Tony Blackburn. Chairman and managing director of H Knitwear and Naughty Clothing, Harry Rogers. Each contestant is assessed in three distinctive categories, which are creative dance routine and visual presentation, artistic interpretation of the music, and personality and stage presence. Our judges vote independently by locking their marks into a computer, which adds up the score and produces the results. In order to give every competitor ample time to perform a routine, a pre-judging session was held at the nightclub of the year, Middlesex and Hearts Country Club, earlier this week. You at home will now have an advantage over our audience here at the Empire, because as the contestants compete individually, the score each received in pre-judging will be revealed on the screen. Dancing now for a place in the next round, for our 32 champions, beginning with a representative from Yugoslavia.
Don't.
seen one half of our world contenders. After the break, 16 more young hopefuls in individual competition. And on stage, second image. All that in part two. So don't go away.
Get away from it all. Experience the tropical taste and the pulsating rhythms of Castaways Nightclub at the Congrove Hotel, Porto Down, every Thursday and Saturday.
What does the future hold for the Belfast shipyard? Chairman John Parker talks about his plans in this month's boardroom. Who are the aristocrats in control of Ulster industry? And what has happened to the plan to give women a place in public life? It's all there in Boardroom, the magazine for decision makers. This month's issue uncovers some of the hidden company successes of the Northwest, and there's an opportunity to win a case of Black Bush. Book your copy now.
Boardroom. Free phone Boardroom.
Through the village where I went to school.
On the Brendan Shine collection, you'll find 16 of Brendan's favourite songs. Songs of love, life, laughter and reflection. The pleasure is all yours with the Brendan Shine collection on album and cassette. Because it's a mousse, new Colour Glow is easy to use, gently colouring and conditioning, even for those with the first signs of grey.
When your hair looks brighter, you feel brighter, so brighten your colour with new Colour Glow.
The kids are needing new clothes, with heavy bills to do.
If you need a little help with money, talk to Providence on this number. We can help.
There's so much we can do to see you through. We can help.
Welcome back. Let's not waste any time as we greet the first of our second half of national champions, the representative from the Netherlands.
Don't. Working with these dynamic performers from all over the world. And now something else quite special and dynamic. The Fab Super Groupalistical Second Image!
Yeah.
Hot for Dogs. Just love that show. We have a special award to present tonight, and this goes to the contestant chosen as the one felt to have been the most helpful to his fellow competitors, the friendliest and most spirited. Here with the trophy is our lovely hostess, Yolanda. Chihuahua. Ay, 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 ay. The championship has produced so many personalities that it comes as no surprise that this award is to be shared between a young man who has unselfishly used his fluency in many languages to help his fellow competitors who do not speak any English, and a young lady who arrived in Britain on Monday with high hopes, but due to unfortunate circumstances, was forced to withdraw from the competition. Yet she has bravely but gamely stayed with the party to cheer on this year's contestants. Please give a warm round of applause to our joint winners, Kevin Sheldrake, representing the Isles of Man, and Christian de Almeida Reed, the national champion of Portugal. Thank you. I've just been handed the computer printout with the names of the 10 national champions who have amassed the highest overall scores to go forward to our second round of competition. They are in no particular order, neither numerically or by score. The national champion of Ireland. The national champion of Denmark. The national champion of Philippines. The national champion of Sweden. The national champion of the United States of America. The national champion of Italy. The national champion of Hungary. The national champion of Iceland. The national champion of United Kingdom. And just one more lucky young person with a chance to become the world disco dancing champion, and he or she is the national champion of Jersey. Prizes being awarded during our disco series are valued in excess of £20,000. And awaiting tonight's world champion is this beautiful brand new car and a dance scholarship. When we return after the break, our top 10 will be competing for the very last time. And we have some other exciting performers like Mezzo Forte and my good friends Errol and Ashley of Imagination to entertain you. So don't touch that dial. We will be back.
Caroline Music November Album Trade-In. We will allow £1 against your old or damaged albums. See Caroline Music Windows or Press for details.
Come out of the shadows. Come out with Color Glow.
Because it's a mousse, new Color Glow is easy to use, gently coloring and conditioning, even for those with the first signs of gray.
When your hair looks brighter, you feel brighter. So brighten your color with new Color Glow.
Hey. Lindsay Leasing's contract hire and leasing plans are the modern way to run business vehicles. We can tailor cost-effective schemes to suit your requirements, aid your cash flow, minimize administration, and usually defer taxation. Our monthly rates are hard to believe, and maintenance contracts include road tax, PSV, all servicing and mechanical repairs with a free loan car. All you pay is the monthly rental, petrol, and insurance. We will even purchase your existing cars for cash, releasing valuable capital for use in your own business. Lindsay Leasing of Lisburn, for contract hire and leasing. A better way to do business.
See the latest in leather, suede and sheepskin fashions at The Sheepskin Shop, 22 Fountain Street, Belfast.
When hi-fi comes with remote control and twin cassettes and good-looking speakers and digital tuning and a linear tracking deck, it also comes expensive as a rule. Happily, every rule has exceptions. Sentra, exceptional hi-fi from £300 to just £99.
Power-packed, red-hot Victory V's will soon ease sore throats and chests that wheeze. Victory V's, in the shops now.
Our judges now have to place in order of preference those fantastic 10 finalists. Here they are all together so you and the judges can compare their styles of dance. Hit it!
Such a shame, such a shame, such a shame. Not a good
even more of an international flavor to our show. From Iceland, so they can cool down some of the heat from the tension that's building up. And with a track from their latest album out soon, please greet Mezzo Forte!
In Greenville, South Carolina, where I'm majoring in theatrical arts, and I'm hoping that this contest will help me.
Well, after winning the UK Championship, I've been amazed at the offers that have come in. It's been amazing. I mean, I've been offered modeling work, dance work, etc.
I'm a student from Reykjavik, and after graduating this Christmas, I can go to university or do whatever I like. And in the future, I would like to become a professional dancer.
I like dancing. I enjoy it very much because I like music and I like rhythm. And if you feel sad someday, you go out dancing. Afterwards, you feel happy.
I've been dancing in about three, four years. And I combined with fashion shows. And I can't explain really why I'm dancing, but it's like a poison in your body. You just got to do it.
I think dancing has become a craze these days. And in order to be good at it, needs hours of practice. I mean, you just have to look around the world, starting from the United States, to see the sort of standards they set. And some of the movements these days are far beyond even understanding.
I'm studying at the Sarasota College in Manila, and I'm hoping to be a medical doctor someday. And I'm very serious with my dancing. And I teach also in Manila. I teach ballet, tap, and modern dance.
I have had some formal training in dancing. I did ballet, modern, and tap from the age of 3 until 15, where I started a job as a hairdresser, and I'm now fully qualified. My sister invented my hairstyle for me. I joined an amateur matics club recently, and we're doing pantomime in Jersey at Christmas.
I'm very happy to be the first ever representative of Hungary in this championship. I'm especially interested to have met all the dancers of different nationalities, not only as dancers but as friends, and also to get to come to London. I find it a beautiful town, most impressive.
I've really been enjoying myself here since I arrived in London, and it's been terrific, the atmosphere. And I'd like to say, I'm a sales rep, but I'd like to say we've had a fabulous time, and the atmosphere is great. And I'd like to say also hello to the people at home who are all watching me in Caribbean Cross, and I hope I do well. You never know.
Thank you.
10 finalists the best of luck and thank all of our national champions for making London a more colorful city this week. To present the prizes, please welcome back from Malibu, Peter Cox, accompanied by Yolanda.
Ladies and gentlemen, the fourth runner-up is a national disco champion of Philippines. The third runner-up is a national disco champion of Iceland. The second runner-up is a national disco champion of Jersey. The next place is very important because for any reason the winner chosen tonight could not fulfill his or her duties, the runner-up will become world champion and the first runner-up is a national disco champion of United Kingdom. Ladies and gentlemen, the new Malibu World Disco Dancing Champion of 1983-84 is the national champion of Italy.
Well, that's it. It's been a supersonic show. And it's just left for me to thank our national champions, our judges, and guest stars. And most of all, you at home for being with us this last 8-9 weeks. Our heartiest congratulations to all.